Laura, over here.
Stefan, I thought you invited me to Windermere for dinner tonight.
I did.
Oh, well then why are you here?
I brought you something.
Oh, they're beautiful.
Your favorite flower, though I never understood why.
I know. They're not ostentatious enough for you. It's their simplicity I like.
Well, I thought they might make your ride across the lake a bit more pleasant.
Well, on a cold night like tonight, they'll be a pleasant reminder of spring.
The season of renewal.
Is the launch waiting?
Yes, but before we go, there's something you should know. Nicholas won't be joining us. He's not at home and isn't expected. Leaving me at a disadvantage, I have nothing to coax you off the mainland with, except the pleasure of my company, should you choose to accept it.
I do. Poor daisies. It's so nice of you to remember.
I could never forget. I'll always make a connection between you and daisies.
Really?
It started in the wild garden. The daisies were in bloom. You were sitting on the ground, surrounded by white and yellow.
Stefan Cassadine, were you spying on me?
I prefer to call it admiring you from afar. As you touch the flowers, you seem to be conversing with either them or yourself.
Well, I guess when I think that I'm alone, I talk to plants and flowers.
Well, I was charmed. I was charmed and curious. I couldn't hear what you were saying, but I still wonder. You seem so earnest. Do you remember the moment?
It was about you.
Me?
I was wondering what it would take to make you laugh.
So what did you come up with to make me laugh? I think I have it. The frogs.
The frogs.
The frogs.
Right. I did. Oh, and you remember that fish stew that Irina used to make, the one that had the tails still in it?
Oh, that is not a dish one easily forgets with the tails in it.
One night I tried so hard to come up with a way to spill it on Helena.
I remember
just to make
that.
You laugh. Yes. I couldn't do it.
What's so funny?
Oh, I'm sorry, Nicholas.
Hi.
Well, come join us. Join us.
Oh, no, thanks. I've already eaten.
So have we. Would you like some coffee?
I have a couple of things to do in my room, but you two enjoy your evening.
Good night.
Night.
Well, our son has come home after all. Does that mean he'll be leaving soon?
Well, if it's all right with you, I'd like to stay. No, it couldn't be.
You recognize it?
Isn't it the music that you used to play in your room on the island? I used to hear it coming from your window all the time.
You called it haunting.
You listened to it for so many hours.
There was such longing in the melody. It was the same as the longing in my heart for you. While you were in the garden thinking about me, I was listening to this, wondering how it would feel to have you in my arms.
Thank you.
Goedemiddag. U spreekt met meneer Van Grube uit Rotterdam. Spreekt u Engels? Ah, natuurlijk. Goed. I would like to make an appointment to review my client's financial holdings. Yeah. Yeah. His name is Cassadine. Goed zo.
Ik ga vanavond naar Amsterdam.
Ik ga vanavond naar Amsterdam. Aangenaam. Mijn naam is Jan-Jaap van Grube. Ik werk voor de bank. Aangenaam. Mijn naam is Peter van Grube. Nee, Jan-Jaap. Ja, dat is beter. De gezin van Grube. Peter. Ja.
Take me back there. I want to be that way again. Without any thought about the consequences of what's going to happen next. What's the matter?
I'm not available for more stolen moments or for rushing headlong into one thing to mask the pain of another. Laura, our time on the island was one of a heightened reality. You were there against your will. I was preparing to wage war against Helena, which was liable to mean my death. But this is the real world. And when we become lovers again, I wanted to be in this world. Under its pressures, despite its circumstances. Because we do believe in tomorrow.
I don't want to live in tomorrow.
we're here now, together. Tonight. I want you. I know that you want me to.
I've always thought that of the two of us, I was the more cynical. It turns out I'm the optimist. I have more faith in us than you do. I'm willing to wait until you can come to me without guilt or reservation or the desperation I see in your face right now.
Not desperate.
Yes, you are. I don't want to be something you throw yourself into in order to forget your marriage.
Why is it that you've always been so able to read me?
Alsjeblieft.
Dank je.
Skål.
Host.
Ja. Dank je wel.
Herr van Gruber, it's so nice to finally put a face to Herr Cassadine's accountant. How many years have we been speaking on the phone?
Oh, hoe laat? Hoeveel lang? Ik weet niet. Too many years, I think. I would have been happy to come naar de bank.
No. This is more convenient. Many of our customers prefer to keep a low profile. Some do not even wish to be seen coming into the country. So I'm accustomed to allowances.
Natürlich.
You're very appreciative that Herr Cassadine honors us with his business.
Yeah. Helix, iets aan de hand? Something is wrong?
Entschuldigung, bitte. All these years, I was expecting an older man.
Een oude man? Oh, dankjewel, meneer. Ik denk dat the years of crunching the numbers...
Sound just like my wife.
Oh ja? Ja. Wel, de vrouw is juist. Mm-hmm. When ik een jonger man was, my sight was 20-20. Ja. Zonder bril, I see fine. But geen again. So, were you able to put everything on the disc we discussed? Yeah.
You will find all of Cassadine's financial holdings summarized here.
All of them?
Yeah. With an index to help you maneuver through the numerous accounts.
Oh, well, my assistants will maneuver through the accounts. Ich bin computer illiterate. Afraid. Yeah, begrijp het, eh? Well, Herr Rix, thank you well.
Oh, bitte.
And now.
Is there any other thing I can be of service for you?
Well, not at the moment. Maar if ik een probleem heb, ik wil bel je.
Ah, I look forward to to speak to you again. Rufen Sie mich, ja?
Ah ja, tot ziens. Doeg. Adedeuven op de dam. Shalalali. Shalalala.
Kom te papa. Kom te papa, mijn kleine meisje. Met de mooi kutje. Aja, aja.
It's late. I should see you home.
Will you hold me? Just for a little while longer.
And in your opinion, Catherine was sincere.
Well, my track record of knowing when Catherine is sincere could be better, but yeah, I thought she meant it.
And her resolve to keep silent can be trusted.
If anything about her can. She's trying very hard to present herself as an honest, decent human being again. And convincing me seems less important than believing in herself.
Well, that may be the end of it then, if she keeps her word. And anyone else who's learned the secret can perhaps be bargained with. In which case, would you reconsider?
What?
Remaining the Prince of the Cassadines.
You know how I feel about this.
I know what you told me when the question first arose, but you've had time to think about it since then. Surely you've had second thoughts. Are there not elements of the life you led that you don't reject?
Well, yeah, of course there are. I may not love the pomp and circumstance, but I understand the traditions, what having a title to hand down does for us. It gives us unity, structure, a rallying point other families don't have. And I understand that this will threaten that, and I know that's my doing. Maybe I even wish there were a Prince Cassadine. Maybe I'll even miss him. But don't ask me to be him, Father.
All right.
I'm sorry.
So am I. But at the same time, I could not be more proud of your answer. I fear you're about to discover another of my secrets. That everything you do seems perilously close to perfect in my eyes. I've completed all the tasks preparatory to an orderly dismantling of the family holdings, lest chaos overtake us. Of course, chaos may ensue in spite of us. The legacy has never been challenged. There's no way to predict the outcome. All that remains now is for you to decide what, if anything, you would like to do with the family fortune while you still control it. If you've had any charities, gifts, even luxuries in mind, now is the time. Yes, this is Mr. Cassadine. I've been reviewing our financial records and noticed there's been a recent attempt to gain access to the complete portfolio. Have you any idea who that might be? Then you will find out and get back to me at once.
Mynheer Cassadine has been watching your organization for a very long time. He is erg impressed with what he sees.
Thank you, Mr. Van Gruber. We at the Prison Reform Society believe that everyone is entitled to a second chance, in some cases a third and fourth.
Javel, meneer, javel. And Meneer Cassadine concurs with that. That is why he has asked me to deliver to you this donation for your organization from the family Cassadine.
Obviously, the Cassadine have a strong commitment to rehabilitation.
Oh, yeah, well, meneer. It is because of the family history. The family Cassadine have a creed that, in Greek, I cannot say because I do not speak the language, but in mine land, in the Netherlands, the translation is, the criminal is mein broer. In Engels, that means the criminal is my brother. Yeah.
Oh, just a moment. Bobby, you have a phone call.
If it's anyone but Lucas, I'm gonna have to call back.
Well, it's not Lucas, but it does sound important.
Why do I know this is Carly?
Hello?
Thank you for calling. I will, I'll be there soon.
Bobby, has something happened? Darling, what's wrong?
It's Ruby.
You said 20 minutes.
There was ice on the lake.
I have an appointment, Stefan. The only reason that I'm here is because old habits are hard to break.
Then I'll be brief. Someone has recently tried to gain access to the family accounts. Given our last conversation, you came to mind.
I'm not a thief. But thanks for the vote of confidence.
You told me directly you intended to raid the family
fortune. I told you that I wanted what was rightfully mine, what was denied me from birth. I didn't say that I would steal it.
Every precaution has been taken to make those accounts secure. It would be impossible to access them without inside information.
I realize. I do. That is very tempting to blame me. But if someone has been tampering with the family accounts, perhaps it's your fault for not paying attention to anything under the sun except Laura Spencer.
There was a time when your understanding my relationship with Laura would have been important to me. Sadly, that time has passed.
Yeah, it's sad, all right. Things change.
Your bitterness continues to mystify me, Alexis. True, I failed to acknowledge that I was Nicholas's father. I masqueraded him as the prince he never was. And yes, I maintained control of a fortune that belonged to the entire family. But I had good reason, Alexis, to protect my son from his murdering grandmother. I expected you, of all people, to understand this.
You expect an awful lot. You know that? Especially from someone who has given so little.
I have been your advocate since we were children. Does that not count for anything?
I was your puppet. You knew that you could control me.
No, it was never that.
Do you realize that in the entire time that I have worked for you, you never allowed me to see one bank statement or a list of the family assets? That bothered me. But I thought, who am I? Who am I to question how he conducts his family business? Well, see, now I know who I am, and I know that that money is just as much mine as it is yours.
Oh, so this is about money, then.
I was an outsider in my own family, which is apparently the way all of you wanted it. You believe me when I tell you that nothing is going to make up for that.
And yet $20 or $30 million could help ease the pain.
This is hysterical. It really is. I think I'm your cousin. It turns out that I'm your sister. I think Nicholas is the prince. It turns out that he's really your son. I've spent my whole life trying to find my proper place in this family. Well, that clearly isn't going to happen, and I'm tired of waiting, so I'm going to take what's mine right now.
Is that why you've been hiring people to investigate our assets? It's pointless to deny it, Alexis. I know.
You haven't been watched. Typical.
You're hiding something else.
So what if I am? Big deal. Do you think you have the patent on deception?
Clearly I don't.
Well, you know what?
I really don't care what you think anymore.
Very well. We have nothing more to say.
I have something to say. You may control the Cassadine fortune, but you don't own it. And you lose one penny, and I will see to it that you answer to every Cassadine on this planet.
And Mynheer Cassadine has been watching your organization for a very long time. He is feeling very strong, hail-sterk, about the work that you do.
He must be a very special man. God bless him.
Oh, well, it is overmarked, huh? But God bless you and the Sisters of Refuge for the work that you do. For giving the Frauen von der Streets, the women of the streets, a better life. Ik begrijp dat. I understand that you are shopping for property.
For a new facility. I don't know how we will ever afford it, but it never hurts to dream.
Well, perhaps this will help make your dream a reality. Oh. Alsjeblieft.
Merci. Oh, mon Dieu. Oh, Mr. Van Grube, this is a lot of money.
Yeah. But Mr. Cassadine wants your facility to be the finest of its kind. Daycare centers and job training programs and all the things necessary for the rehability of the women of the street. And make them happy.
That is what we are going to do. You have my pledge. Might there be a way for me to thank Mr. Cassadine personally?
Nay. Mynheer Cassadine is een klein beetje eccentriek. Shy. But you can pray that his soul spends eternity where it belongs.
Told me she had a heart condition.
Miss Anderson knew it was fatal when she contacted me about the arrangements. She requested that I respect her privacy.
She probably didn't want anybody to fuss over her.
Actually, those were her exact words.
I know that we need to set a date for her memorial, but I would like to wait until I can contact my brother.
Let me know when you're ready.
Like a mother to you.
More like a whole family. I can't believe I'm never going to see her again. You know, there's no chance to say goodbye or thank you or anything. Ruby just dies in her sleep one night, and suddenly it's just all over. I mean, somehow that doesn't seem right.
It never does. Now, if you would like to go home, I'll be glad to keep you company.
Thanks. I'm not ready to leave.
Would you rather be alone?
I won't be.
Let me know when I can do something for you.
Thanks.
I gave you permission to use the tunnels?
You can never have too much secrecy, Mr. Cassadine. Why do you want to see me?
Someone has been attempting to access my business accounts.
You paid me well enough for my services. I've got no reason to double-cross you.
I wasn't accusing you. I merely want you to be on the alert in case you hear anything.
Well, if you'd like to give me the details, I'd be happy to look into it.
I prefer to handle this myself.
Anything else?
Yes. Leave through the front door.
Kelly's.
Hey, little sister, what's up? Ruby got you on phone duty?
I only wish.
Bobby? What's wrong?
Ruby had a heart attack, Luke. She died in her sleep.
Okay. Well, you hang on. I'll be there as soon as I can.
That's not like Ruby. Ruby?
I tried to reach you. It's Ruby. What? She's gone.
Glad you're here. You've just saved me from reviewing yet another legal brief. An obvious misnomer. Are you still interested in taking the horses to the South Shore? Or has the weather turned too cold?
It is a little brisk out there.
Something happened? Is it your mother?
No. My mother's fine. She's better, in fact. It's just that on my way to the launch, I ran into a couple of Luke's friends. They didn't know that I saw them, but anyway, I just felt like... I felt like they caught me doing something wrong. Luke may have left me, but I'm still not free. I was at the hospital when they called me about Ruby, and it just felt so wrong, and I started thinking maybe it was a mistake, even though I know that sounds crazy.
I
I had a bad feeling. She came to me in a dream 5 or 6 nights ago. And I hadn't spoken with her since New Year's. And I was supposed to call her. I don't really remember the dream, except she was giving me one of those bone-withering glares of hers, and I woke up in a cold sweat.
Yeah, well, you always knew where you stood with Ruby. And you always knew she'd be there.
What would have happened to us, Barbara Jean, if she hadn't taken us in and made us family all those years ago? She had no idea what she was getting herself in for.
But she didn't quit, and she didn't kick us out.
Well, maybe not you. She showed me the door several times.
Yeah, well, she always let you back in.
Yeah, but that was because she was a tough, crusted cookie with a big, soft marshmallow heart. She liked the challenge. She liked us keeping her on her toes.
Yeah, well, we did that. I keep thinking she's gonna walk in.
All the times I left this town, I never looked back, thinking it would be the last time I would ever see her.
Because we always thought she'd be there. I went upstairs a little while ago, and I was looking at all those pictures. And I thought, gosh, she really lived life. And she was blessed with a lot of people who loved her.
She was easy to love.
I'm glad you're here.
I'm just glad Bobby reached you.
Thank you.
I'm sorry.
No, I know.
What do you want me to do?
Well, the people will be coming soon, so we should probably put the coffee on and start setting out the food.
Okay, why don't you stay here with Luke and I'll get things moving.
Thank you, Felicia.
Be able to find Laura. Thank you. Thank you.
The other night, when you slowed things down and said that I wasn't ready yet, you were right. Thank you.
My motives were purely selfish, Laura. When you come to me, I don't want anyone else in the room. In the meantime, I see no reason we can't spend time together. Unless it will make you uncomfortable.
No. I appreciate your patience.
That's my strong suit.
Have you spoken to Laura?
No, I came straight here.
I didn't want her to find out from an answering machine, so I just left her a message asking her to call me when she could. Lucky was away overnight on a school field trip, but he got back this morning, so I told him. Maybe he's found her.
How'd he take it?
Like you. Elizabeth was with him and they went for a walk, but they said they'd be back for the gathering.
What about little Lucas?
Jerry took him for the afternoon, but he's so sad. I hate how much loss he's had.
Yeah.
Well, what needs to be done in terms of arrangements?
Well, Ruby wanted a big open house for all of her friends and family to drink the coffee and eat the chili and trade exaggerated stories about her. There's still time for you to take a walk if you'd like.
Yeah, maybe that would be good. I sure love you.
I love you too.
I'll be back. Hey. Hi, Mike.
Good to see you back.
Thanks.
Sorry about Ruby.
Yeah. Heard my old partner was in town. Hey!
Dude! Hey.
Don't make me fight dirty. Hey, you didn't wear that hat.
What hat?
The hat I told you to wear in all that damn sunshine. So that your brain wouldn't, you know, bake. You gotta be fried, man. What are you doing, leaving a tropical paradise to come to the Chuckles in the middle of the winter?
I'm a suit guy, you know that. You know anything about suits?
Suits. The three-piece thing.
Yeah.
I had one of those on about 3 days ago.
You get a picture?
No, man, it was too gruesome. I look like an accountant. How you doing?
I'm doing fine. How you doing?
I'm okay.
Yeah. Sorry about Ruby.
Yeah, thanks. Okay. What are you really doing here?
Didn't you always tell me not to throw my life away?
Yeah, I guess so. But, anytime anybody tells me I'm right, I guess I'll believe them. But if you think that I'm gonna believe that you're here for any other reason than Moreno, then I think you have toasted your cauliflower.
I'm through with that business.
Really? I'm not. Still a lot of people out there I'd like to see disappear.
Well, it's getting a little too cold for me. I'm gonna go ahead and head on to the grill.
I'm gonna stay here and enjoy the view. All right. I don't suppose we'll see you at Kelly's later.
Why? Is there something going on there?
Yeah. You should have called Bobby back. Ruby's dead.